My house shall be called a house of prayer. God's highest purpose in prayer is for intimacy with Him. But His primary reason for giving His life on the cross was to reconcile us to God. His primary reason was to take a relationship that had been broken in the Garden of Eden, to take a relationship where man used to walk with God and talk with God and commune with Him and have fellowship with Him, an unbroken relationship that was broken because of sin. God intended that all of creation would have relationship with Him. God is a God of relationship. He wants to spend time with you, and He wants you to spend time with Him. And Jesus shed His blood to give you access into the very presence of God. Jesus shed His blood so that you could know Him, and He could know you, and that you could be the friend of God. You have access to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the most holy, almighty Creator of the universe. You have direct, divine, unhindered access to God.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our 10 days of prayer. So we will be your hosts. I'm Joy. Good evening, Pastor Tanette.
Good evening, Joy, yes. And good evening to our dearest pastors, to our outer chest, to our leaders as well, mga team of prayer.
Yes.
Good evening po. And good evening din po sa ating mga...
Even sa mga nanonood sa atin abroad, if yung mga family natin, relatives or friends na nanonood, so we want to welcome you. Good evening po sa inyo mula dito sa Pilipinas. And also sa ating mga ministry team, care group leaders, yan. So lahat, even members natin. And also, kung napadpad ka dito, parang nagbabrowse ka lang, and then it happened na bigla mo siyang napindot at nanonood ka ngayon, we believe that God has a purpose sa iyo, and God will minister. So welcome.
Yeah, and that's right, Joy. And you know what? This is very important night.
Yes, and we are so excited.
Yeah, we are excited.
Yeah.
This is the heart of our senior pastors, Bishop Ritz and Pastor Ning.
Yes.
They really the desire of their heart is to have a team of prayer who are praying 24/7. And you know, that's why we started the 24/7 prayer here in Fairview. And I heard also from our outreaches, they already started that.
Yes.
The prayer chain, they also did that, the prayer chain. And you know, that is so important because prayer is the backbone
of the church, and it's very, very important. We heard po many na testimonies when they prayed na talagang marami yung na-answer na panalangin, because we believe God is the God who answers our prayers.
Yes, exactly, Joy. Yeah. And you know what? What is the purpose? What is it? But I want you to expect from God to really wait for the anointing of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
You know, our theme for the 10 days prayer is all about repentance and revival.
Yes.
That's why we need to repent. You know, sometimes you will feel like, na ako'y Kristiyano, bakit ko pa kailangan mag-repent?
Yes, yes.
But we unconsciously, actually, hindi natin alam na tayo nagkakasala o hindi natin alam tayo nakakasakit sa ating kapwa,
yes,
right? That's why Book of James said, kung ikaw ay hindi na nakakasakit sa iyong kapwa sa pamamagitan ng pananalita, you are already perfect. Yeah. That's why, mapapansin mo na kung saan na yung cycle ng Christianity is repentance, actually.
Yes, yes.
That's why repentance is important. That these 10 days of prayer is a time for us as family, as church, as, you know,
even
Christians,
as an individual,
as individual, as Christians, that's important for us. Na talagang makita natin na God, ako ba ay tama pa sa'yo?
Yes.
We need to. This is the time for us to search our heart.
Yes, that's true, Pastor.
Yeah, yeah.
And also para din ano, na ma-refresh tayo.
Exactly.
Talagang ma-revive. Kasi there are many things happening around us when we watch yung sa TV natin or even sa mga social media. So everything, marami. We're bombarded of many issues sa life. So we really need to go back.
That's
talaga
right.
Sa presence ng Lord.
Yeah.
And this ano po talaga is timely. Itong 10 days of prayer talaga. We believe that God will really move dito po sa ating 10 days of prayer.
Yeah, exactly. And actually, hindi lang po tayo ang nananalangin.
Yes,
as
po.
Victory Churches of Asia. Actually, the global, the world are joining.
Yes.
They're in, also praying. In this prayer. Mm-hmm. And I want you to really really see the anointing of the Lord,
mm-hmm.
the presence of God, and we need to really pursue.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
To run after
mm-hmm.
the presence of
yes.
the Lord. That's
yes.
important. Mm-hmm. And tonight, let's prepare our hearts.
Yes.
Get excited.
Yes.
Tune in. This is only a 45 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. So from September 16 this night until September 26, so every 7 p.m.
That's right.
You can join us po. And we believe na talagang God will do amazing in our midst. So let's ano talaga ready our hearts, Pastor.
That's
no?
right.
Talaga as
Amen.
We as we listen, as we worship.
Mm.
So we will not just only listen, but also we will worship. Let's engage our heart talaga to connect with the Lord.
The presence of God is right here.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we need to welcome Him
yes.
with all our hearts. He deserves honor. He deserves worship tonight.
Spirit of the living God, Spirit of the living God, we only want to hear your voice. We're hanging on every word. Spirit of the living God, Spirit of the living God, we want to know you more and more. We're hanging on every else can it changes us, it changes what we see and what we see.
Children and the children.
nations and your family and your children and the children and the children makes presence go before you and behind you and beside you all around you and within you is with you is with you in the morning in the evening and you're coming and you're going and you're weeping and rejoicing he's for you he's for you
If you have your Bibles, I'd like you to turn with me to the book of Hosea and chapter 10. I'm reading from verse 11 in the New International Version. Hosea chapter 10 and verse 11. Now the Bible says, Ephraim is a trained heifer that loves to thresh. So I put a yoke on her fair neck. I will drive Ephraim. Judah must plow and Jacob must break up the ground. Sow righteousness for yourselves, reap the fruit of unfailing love, and break up your unplowed ground, for it is time to seek the Lord until he comes and showers righteousness on you. But you have planted wickedness, you have reaped evil, you have eaten the fruit of deception, because you have depended on your own strength and on your many warriors. So we all know Hosea was a prophet during the days of Israel. It was a unique time. He was during the reign of King Jeroboam the second, and it just so happened at the time Israel was greatly prosperous. Israel was prospering at that time, and yet Hosea is raised up by the Lord to call the nation of Israel to repentance. Because in their prosperity, they had turned their backs on God. They had begun to worship the gods of other nations. The ruling class had begun to oppress the poor, and they were making alignments with ungodly nations. And so God raised up the prophet Hosea to call the nation to repentance. I think that we can all identify. It is time to seek the Lord until he comes. The prophet Hosea calls his church to repentance. So I'd like us to just take a moment here and go through this passage from Hosea chapter 10, verse 11 to 13, verse by verse. And so again, if you have your Bibles, let's start in verse 11. The scripture says, Ephraim is a trained heifer that loves to thresh, so I put a yoke on her fair neck. I will drive Ephraim. Judah must plow and Jacob must break up the ground. Judah must plow and Jacob must break up the ground. Judah means praise, doesn't it? And so the prophet is making a declaration here that it's through the praise and the worship of our God that we begin to break up the fallow ground of our hearts. Israel had forgotten her God. Israel had depended upon her own strength. She had even turned to the gods of other nations, forgetting the Lord. And God raised up Hosea to call them to repentance. And so Hosea says, Judah must plow. We have got to plow through praise and worship, through focusing our attention upon God, through focusing our attention on the greatness of our God. We can plow up that hardened heart. We can plow up that ground that has been hardened through forsaking the Lord. And then he says that not only must Judah must plow, but Jacob must break up the ground. You know, when I think of Jacob, the first thing I think of is that encounter that he had with God. The Bible tells us that he wrestled with the Lord all night long, mug to mug. He cried out to God and he asked for God to rescue him, asked for God to bless him. You know, if you remember the story there, the Bible says that he took hold of the angel of the Lord and he says, I will not let you go until you bless me. All night long, wrestling with God in prayer, he asked for God to rescue him. All night long, rescuing with God in prayer, he asked for God to bless him. And so we know the story. The angel of the Lord touched his hip. It went out of socket. He began to walk with a limp. But the Bible says that God changed him. He changed his name from Jacob the deceiver, Jacob the conniver. He became Jacob the prince with God. And so I believe this is a time that you and I have got to have the spirit of Judah, the spirit of praise, the spirit of worship, and we've got to have the spirit of Jacob, a spirit that wrestles with God, a spirit that says, I'll not let go of God until he blesses me. I'll not let go of God until he rescues me. I'll not let go of God until he comes and changes my situation. We have got to have the spirit of Jacob and the spirit of Judah. Verse 12 in Hosea chapter 10 says, sow righteousness for yourselves, reap the fruit of unfailing love. Break up your unplowed ground, for it is time to seek the Lord. Nais kong ulitin. Sow righteousness for yourselves, reap the fruit of unfailing love, break up your unplowed ground, for it is time to seek the Lord until he comes and showers his righteousness on you. Again, Hosea was called of God to call the people of God back to repentance, back to seeking the Lord, back to putting God first. And so he says here that it's time for us to seek the Lord. It is time, mga kapatid, it is time for you and I to seek the Lord. The Bible says that when we seek him with all of our hearts, that is when we will find him. It is time for us to begin to cry out to God, even as Jacob wrestled with the Lord. It is time for us to seek the Lord until he comes and rains righteousness on us. Again, the prophet is calling us to repentance. He's calling us to turn from our sins, to turn from our wicked ways, to get on our faces before God, to begin to seek him until he comes and restores us, until he comes and rescues us, until he comes and rains his righteousness on us. The Bible says that the nation that serves the Lord, the nation that is a righteous nation, will be blessed of God. Mga kapatid, it is time for us to seek the Lord until he comes and showers righteousness on us. You know, the nation of Israel, they had been lifted up in pride. They had prospered greatly under King Jeroboam, and yet they had turned away from the Lord in the midst of God's blessing upon the nation. They had turned from the Lord. They had looked to ungodly idols. They had put their trust in other nations. They had made alignments with Syria and Egypt. They had looked to the other nations to be their resource and not looked unto God. And so the prophet Hosea is raised up by God to call the nation to repentance. You know, we all know the story here. Hosea ends up marrying an unfaithful wife. He ends up marrying a woman who, is having an affair with other men. And this was a picture of the unfaithfulness of Israel. This was a picture of the nation of Israel who had turned their back on God and began to seek other means of blessing in their life. They had begun to turn to the false gods. They'd begin to turn to other nations. Rather than depending upon God, they were looking to man to heal. They were looking to man to bless them. And the prophet Hosea is raised up by the Lord to call the nation to repentance. And so he says, sow righteousness for yourselves, reap the fruit of unfailing love, break up your unplowed ground, for it is time. Mga kapatid, it is time. It is time to seek the Lord. It is time for the body of Christ to come together and to turn to God in prayer. It is time for us to put God first. It is time for us to get rid of the arm of the flesh, to not depend upon our own strength, to not depend upon the blessings that we have received, but to look to God, to fall on our faces to God, before God, and cry out to Him for His mercy. And so He says that we are to break up the unplowed ground. It's time to seek the Lord until He comes and rains righteousness on you. And then verse 13 of the same chapter says this, Hosea chapter 10 and verse 13, you have planted wickedness, you have reaped evil, you have eaten the fruit of deception. Why? Because you have depended on your own strength and on your many warriors. Look at the word of the Lord here. I mean, Jeremiah says the same thing when he says, the pride of your heart hath deceived you. This is a call from the Lord to turn back to dependence upon God. We can't depend upon others. We can't depend upon the government. We can't even depend upon medical science. We have got to turn back to God. We have got to look to the Lord. He is the answer. Now, mga kapatid, I want to make it very clear here today that, I believe in medical science. I believe in how vaccines work and all these kind of things. All my kids were vaccinated. I'm no anti-vaxxer. But listen, the vaccine is not the answer. God is the answer. Prayer is the answer. Getting on our face before God is the answer. The government cannot save us. Even medical science, we should not be depending just upon medical science. I'm not against medical science, but we should not put our dependence upon medical science. It is the Lord who can save us. The Bible says, they that call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. We've got to cry out to God, not depend upon the arm of the flesh, not depend upon our own understanding, not looking to man for deliverance. We look to God for deliverance. And so this is the call of the Lord from the prophet Hosea. And it's a rebuke. It's a rebuke. He says, you have eaten the fruit of deception. Deny upon natin sarili natin. Because we are depending on our own strength. Because we're not calling out to God. We're not crying out to God. We're waiting for the arm of the flesh to come and save us. Again, don't misunderstand me. I believe in medical science. But medical science is not our Savior. Jesus Christ is our Savior. He is the one who will save us. And so it is time for us to seek the Lord until He comes and rains righteousness on us. It's time for us to turn our backs on sin, to turn our backs on the arm of the flesh, to turn our backs on dependence upon man, and to get on our faces before God. It is time to seek the Lord until He comes and rains righteousness on us. Mga kapatid, we've got to have a heart that seeks after God. We've got to have a heart that searches after Him. We've got to have a heart that is hungry for God. We've got to have a heart that will seek Him with all of our heart. You know, the Bible says this, you will seek Him and you will find Him when you search for Him with all of your heart. I thank God for our leaders in HIM and PCEC who are calling the church to prayer, calling the church to repentance, calling the church to get on its face before God, begin to cry out to Him and to ask God for deliverance. It's not the government that will deliver us. It's not medical science that will deliver us. It's God that will deliver us. And so it is time to seek the Lord until He comes. It's time to repent of our unfaithfulness. Even as Hosea married that unfaithful woman as a picture of an unfaithfulness. Someone who wants love from her husband, but also wants love from another. You know, it's kind of like half-hearted Christians. We want the love and the blessing of God, but we also want the love and the blessing of the world. It doesn't work. God is calling us to wholehearted repentance. He's calling us to seeking Him with all of our hearts, all of our might, and all of our strength. It is time to seek the Lord until He comes and rains righteousness on us. You know, again, I'm reminded as Jacob wrestled all night with God in prayer, crying out to God for his deliverance, crying out to God that God would touch him, that God would change him. You know, the Bible says that that angel touched him and changed his name from Jacob the deceiver to Prince with God because he had prevailed. Mga kapatid, we can prevail in prayer. We can prevail with God because of the blood of Jesus, because of what Jesus did on the cross. The Bible says that we have unhindered access to the very presence of God, the throne room of heaven. It's time for us to seek the Lord. It's time for us to repent, to come back to God, to stop depending upon our own strength, to not look to the government to deliver us, to not look to medical science to deliver us, but to look to the Lord to deliver us. He is our deliverer. He is our refuge. He is our Savior. He is the one who will come and save us. And so during this time of crisis, it is time that we seek the Lord until He comes and rains righteousness on us. David said in Psalm chapter 34 and verse 4, I sought the Lord and He heard me and He delivered me from all my fears. Amen? He heard me and He delivered me. It's God who will hear us. It's God who will deliver us. I sought the Lord and He heard me. Mga kapatid, we serve a God who hears and answers prayer. And if you and I will unite together and begin to seek God with all of our heart, if we will turn from our wicked ways, the Bible says He will heal our land. It's time to seek the Lord until He comes. In other words, There's a persevering, there's a prevailing prayer. It's not just saying a bless me prayer. It's not just praying a blessing over your food. It's pursuing God in prayer. It's like Jacob wrestling with God in prayer. It's like that importune widow coming to the Lord again and again, seeking to the Lord, the scripture says, until He comes. Until He comes and rescues us. Until He comes and saves us. Until He comes and delivers us. God is our deliverer. It is time to seek the Lord until He comes and rains righteousness on us. You know, the Bible says that judgment begins at the household of God. If we have depended upon our own strength, if we have not wholeheartedly looked unto the Lord to be our Savior, to be our deliverance, to be the one who rescues us. If we have leaned upon the arm of the flesh, then it's time to turn our hearts back to God. It's time to look unto our salvation. There is no other. His name is Jesus. He alone can save us. And so as I close this message here today, I want to encourage us as the body of Christ to mobilize our believers, to mobilize our leaders, to get in small groups, to get online, to begin to pray like never before. It is God alone who can save us. It is time to seek the Lord until He comes. You know, the key of worship and prayer and worship and praise is that it puts our focus on the greatness of God. Amen? When we begin to praise Him, when we begin to worship Him, when we begin to lift our hands, then we are not looking at the circumstances anymore. We're not looking unto men anymore. We're not looking unto governments or even science. Nothing wrong with those things. But it is only God who can save us. And so if we'll turn our faces toward God and begin to seek Him with all of our hearts and focus on Him, lift our hands and worship Him and see the greatness of our God and begin to call on the name of the Lord, they that call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Mga kapatid, Jesus is the answer. The government won't save us. Even medical science cannot save us. It is God alone who can save us. Let's bow our hearts in a word of prayer in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you that you are a God who hears and answers prayer. We thank you, God, that you are a God who will intervene on our behalf. If we will set our faces like a flint, if we will seek you with all of our heart, with all of our might, if we will be like Jacob, if we will be like that importune widow, oh God, and wrestle with you in prayer, you will rescue us. You have proven down through the generations, oh God, that when your people cry out to you, you hear from heaven and you save us. And so, God, we commit ourselves as leaders in the body of Christ. We commit ourselves to prayer. We commit ourselves to turn away from dependence upon the flesh, to turn away from our own strength, to turn away from looking outside of you to be rescued. Lord, we commit ourselves to look unto you and to cry out to you with all of our hearts. And we believe that you will come, you will hear, and you will answer our prayer. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your King. The same.
So good, your loving Father, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's in tune our hearts in prayer tonight. Let us really focus ourselves to God, to Him, really. What the Word of God said from 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14 says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Tonight, let us really come into the presence of God. Isuko natin yung ating puso sa Panginoon, yung ating sarili sa Panginoon. It's a time of heart searching. Allow the Holy Spirit to search our hearts, to search the mind. The Holy Spirit has power to remind us what is in the heart, what is the motive of the heart. Today, let us surrender our mind, our five senses, the mind, the heart, surrender it to Him. Lord, we surrender it to You, Father. Ang aming mga sarili, ang aming isip, puso, ang aming mga pananalita, ang aming mga gawa, sinusuko po namin sa Iyo, Panginoon. Lord, nandito kami sa Iyong harapan, nais naming makaranas ng divine appointment from You, Holy Spirit. A divine touch from You, my King. God, we need You. We need Your touch. We need Your love. And today, Lord, we repent. Kung kami po ay nagkulang sa Iyo, kung kami ay hindi na nananalangin, kung kami, Panginoon, ay sa aming hindi pakikinig sa Iyong boses, patawarin mo po kami, Panginoon, sa aming mga pagdedesisyon na hindi ka namin ini-inquire. Lord, forgive us, God, in Jesus' name, na naging dahilan to ng disappointments, na nag-end up kami sa tinatawag na kalungkutan. Lord, forgive us. Lord, ngayon, nais naming hanapin ang Iyong mukha at nais naming marinig ang Iyong boses. Holy Spirit, come. Open the eyes of our understanding. Open our ears, Lord God, to hear from You, Father God, in Jesus' name. And we pray, God, and ask that You would touch the heart, change the way we think, my Lord, and cause us, O Lord God, to be obedient to Your words. Come, Holy Spirit, Your words is enough. As You have promised, as You have said, as we humble ourselves to You, Jesus, to You, God, to You, Jesus, and pray and seek Your face. Sinabi mo, Panginoon, na kami, Panginoon, na yung diringgin. Kung kami tatalikod sa aming mga kasalanan, ang langit ay yung bubuksan, ang pabor ay ibibigay mo sa amin. Lord, move. Move, my Lord. Touch our hearts. Make You, God, in our life. Lord, sa araw na ito, sinasabi po sa Iyo, maging Diyos ka ng aking buhay. Maging Diyos ka ng aking isip, ng aking pananalita. Maghari ka po sa pangalan ni Jesus.
And also this evening, let's also pray for our family. If kasama mo yung family mo, katabi mo siya, let's agree together in prayer and just speak Him blessing. And also, if there is mga bitterness or may mga conflict, this is the time to release forgiveness. This is the time to seek yung peace sa family. Let's together, let's agree in prayer. Father God, we thank You for every family, God. Yung family that we have, Lord. Lord, we thank You that You love, Lord, yung aming mga magulang, yung aming mga kapatid, yung bawat isa, Lord God, sa aming family, Lord God. And Lord, this evening, Father, we just surrender, God, to You, Lord, our families, Lord God. We just ask for Your mercy and Your grace, Lord. If we allow conflict, Lord, in our family, if we allow yung mga bitterness or even sa mga anak, Panginoon, that if we allow yung mag-disobey sa aming parents, Lord God, Lord, we ask for Your forgiveness. We ask for Your mercy, Lord God. Lord, we pray for Your healing, God. Let Your healing come, Lord, in every relationship, Lord. Yung mga magulang sa anak at anak sa magulang, Panginoon, and even, Lord God, yung mga biyanan, Panginoon, sa kanilang mga manugang, Lord God, and even sa mga lola at apo, Panginoon, at apo sa lola, Panginoon, or lolo, Lord God, sa mga relatives, relatives, Lord God. Lord, we just ask, God, that you come also sa aming family, Lord God. Lord, visit us, God. We just ask, God, for your grace and your mercy, Lord God, and your healing, God. Heal every heart, Lord. Heal every brokenness, God, in Jesus' name. Even mga disappointments, God. Lahat, Panginoon, we just surrender everything to you, Lord. And we just ask, God, na ikaw yung maging Diyos ng aming pamilya, God. Ng aming pamilya, hindi lang ng buhay ng bawat isa, but yung buhay, God, sa bawat pamilya, God, sa bawat tahanan, God. Let there be peace, God, in Jesus' name. And Lord, we also speak, Panginoon, God, that salvation, Lord. Lord, you said in your word, God, that believe in the Lord Jesus, you will be saved, you and your household. Lord, we hold on, Panginoon, we hold on. God, we pray for those mga Christians, God, sa family na they feel na parang hindi na answer yung prayer nila or parang bakit walang pagbabago. God, we believe, Lord. We choose to believe, Lord. And God, we just we thank you, Lord, that nothing is impossible, Lord God, sa inyo. That, Lord, you are, God, nag-create ng family, and we believe, Lord, that you are also, God, yung author, God, ng healing, God, yung author ng peace, Lord God. Ikaw yung author, Panginoon, God, ng unity, Lord. We speak unity, God, for there is unity, God, you command your blessing, and we continually declare, God, unity, God, sa bawat pamilya, Lord God. We thank you, God, that you are the God. Lord, we declare this evening that you are the God of every family, God, of every relationship ng mag-asawa, Panginoon, God, ng mga anak, Lord God. We declare that you are the God and the Lord of every family. Lord, we thank you for your peace. We thank you for your healing. God, we just receive it. We just receive it, God. Your healing, your peace, even your provision, God, and your guidance in every family. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Abba. We honor you, Lord.
Let's all pray for our church. Kung saan ka umaattend the church. Let's all pray for the church. Let's all pray sa mga kapatiran. We are the church. I am the church. You know, hindi lang yung leadership ng church, but also we are the church. And we need to really pray sa mga kapatiran na to. Naaalala mo ang kanilang mga pangalan, mention their name. Lord, we pray, God, sa aming mga kapatiran na ito, sa pangalan ni Jesus. We pray, Father in heaven, in Jesus' name, that you would bring unity, my Lord, in the church, in every relationship in the church, in Jesus' name. God, forgive us kung meron pong disunity, kung merong discord, kung meron pong mga chismis na nangyayari, Lord. Lord, forgive us. Patawarin po kami, Panginoon. Nagniniklohod kami sa iyong harapan, nanunumbalik sa iyong presensya. Lord, patawarin mo kami sa aming pagkakanya-kanya. Patawarin mo kami, Panginoon, sa aming paggrupo-grupo. Patawarin mo kami, Panginoon, kung kami, Panginoon, ay laging naghahanap ng mali at namumuna ng mali at hindi lang yun pinag-uusapan namin ng mali. Lord, forgive us, Lord. Help us to find solutions instead. In Jesus' name. Lord, I ask your grace. I ask your mercy for the church. In Jesus' name. Sa mga kapatiran, babae at lalaki, kabataan, mga bata at mga young professional. Lord, I pray that you would bless God in Jesus' name ang mga mananampalatayang ito sa pangalan ni Jesus, na ang anointing of your Holy Spirit ay mararanasan nila, that the anointing of the Holy Spirit, God, ay patuloy pong itutulak sila na magpatuloy at magsasabi, Panginoon, at magre-respond kami, Panginoon, na yes, Lord, we want to obey you until the end in Jesus' name, and we want to be patient, we want to be faithful until the end. Lord, move by your Holy Spirit, my Lord, in Jesus' name.
Yes, God. Yes, Lord. And also, we would like to pray for God's grace and mercy. Kung nasaan kayo ngayon, kung anong town, kung anong barangay, kung anong city, let's just, even the nation Philippines, let's just speak yung blessing over yung lugar kung nasaan tayo, and also let's just speak yung peace ni God. Pwede mo siyang banggitin habang tayo na nanalangin. Father God, we thank you, God, for the place, Lord God, kung saan mo kami dinala, God. For you have a purpose, Lord God. We thank you sa bawat barangay, kung saan kami belong, Lord God, sa bawat town, Lord, sa bawat province, O God. And even we thank you for the nation, Philippines. God, salamat na meron kang purpose kung bakit mo kami, God, dinala sa isang lugar, Panginoon. And God, we just pray, God, and speak, God, your blessing, God, kung saan kami belong, Lord God, sa city, God, kung saan kami belong, if it is in Caloocan, God, if it is in Quezon City or in Bulacan area, Lord God, kung sa Quezon man to, God, kung anumang part ng probinsya, God, we just speak, God, your blessing, God, and even protection, God, kung saan kami, Panginoon, nakalagay, Panginoon. God, we speak, even God, yung mercy mo, God, sa lugar namin, Panginoon. God, we just ask for your mercy and your grace, yes. God. And even, Panginoon, if we allow, God, dun sa community namin na parang wala kaming pakialam, God, sa mga kapitbahay namin, or we just go along lang, God, yung life without even sharing your word, God, or without reaching them, God, or showing yung mercy mo or yung grace mo, God, over them. God, we just ask for your forgiveness. Yes. We ask for your forgiveness, God. If we hindi namin tinignan yung kapitbahay namin or yung kapwa namin, Panginoon, ng may compassion or ng may pag-ibig or parang baliwala lang yung lahat. God, forgive us. Yes. Forgive us, Father. Forgive us, Father. Or even, God, if we mock, God, our authorities, God, over kung saan kami belong, God, na authority, God, na place, God. Forgive us, Father. Forgive us, Lord. In Jesus' name. God, we pray, Lord, that you bless the city where we belong, God. We pray, Father, God, that give us this big heart, Lord. Give us this big heart, God, to love, Lord, to pray, God, for the city, God, for the province, God, where we belong, Lord, God, that we will pray, God, that we will speak your truth, Lord, and we will have this love, Lord, big heart, God, for those people around us, Lord, God, that even in our smiles, God, even yung as we lend our hands, God, to other, God, na makikita that we have a God, that we have a big God, that we represent you, Lord, God. That we represent you, Panginoon, God, in the place where we belong, God. And even we pray, God, for your grace also and your mercy over the nation Philippines, God. That there are many things happening around us, Panginoon, God, sa aming bansang Pilipinas. And God, we cannot do it on our own, God. And we believe, Lord God, that you are mighty, that you are powerful, God, over our nation. And we just declare that you are the God of the Philippines, Lord. Lord, we pray yung mga promises mo, God, over our nation, God. Yung mga prophecy that we receive, Panginoon, God, over our nations, Panginoon. That we will fight for it, Lord God. That we will fight for it. That this nation is a Christian nation. That you are the God of this nation. Lord, we continually declare, Jesus, that you are the God. That you are the God of Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. That this nation is for you, God. That we belong, God. We belong, Lord God, to you, Panginoon. God, salamat that this nation has a future. We have a future because you are our God. And Lord, we just receive, God, yung love mo, God, over our nation, God, in Jesus' name. And even, Panginoon, God, we just speak, God, yung mga promises mo, God, yung words mo, God, over our nation, Philippines. Lord, we thank you for your love, Lord. We thank you, God, for your peace. We thank you for your grace, Lord God. We thank you, God, that the neighboring nations, Panginoon, will see and know that you are the God of the Philippines. Lord, we honor you. We honor you, God. We honor you and we praise you. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Holy Spirit, for your presence tonight. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your grace. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Tomorrow, see you at 7 p.m. Prepare your heart. Yes. So umaga pa lang. Pray with your family, cry out to God, seek the presence of God, soak in His presence. God bless you and good night.